Hello, Internet. James Allen from Out of 8, and today I'm playing open-world action-adventure game Just Cause 3. In it, you basically go around a series of islands and just blow stuff up. The game this time around does not have any multiplayer. They modded in multiplayer into Just Cause 2, but it doesn't have any multiplayer here, although it does have online leaderboards for a ton of different stats, which will probably pop up here as soon as I start the game here. So let's do that. While I was sitting at the menu, apparently some of the bad guys infiltrated my village. And they just took them out, so good for them. So basically there are a single player campaign, which is the main story that you can pretty much ignore if you want to. There's a fairly large map here that I've tried to unlock some of the stuff through as I've progressed through the game. Basically set across 4 or 5 different islands here. What you can do is you can go through and liberate all these villages, and then that'll turn the province blue. And then you, you know, your basic goal is to try to turn everything over to the rebels instead of to the oppressive general that's in charge here. When you do the main story, once you get past the first couple missions that unlock things like fast travel and the rebel drops, you can basically kind of ignore the missions, kind of go around and just mess around. The missions themselves are pretty repetitive. It's a lot of timed missions or escort missions where your friendly units like to die more often than they should. Although I will say that the difficulty in this is way less than in Just Cause 2, which is a very nice feature. Just Cause 2, once you got up to like 5 heat level, it became very frustrating and you died very easily. And it's not the case this time around. Even when you die, it saves all the progress you've done in liberating different villages, which is nice. So it's definitely less frustrating than it was before. Other than the main story, you can liberate villages, which I've actually liberated this village here that I'm in now. You can also go around and do different challenges. There's this boat challenge over here, 123 meters away. Driving cars, using the wingsuit, stuff like that. And also these little randomized encounters, and we'll see if we kind of run into any of those as we progress along here. As in the previous version of the game, you can carry 3 weapons. You get basically a pistol or submachine gun, main weapon, and also a special weapon like an RPG launcher or a sniper rifle. You also get grenades, and you also get an infinite supply of these little rocket C4 type things, which I'm going to experiment with here in a little bit. Also, as before, you have your grapple, and you have unlimited parachutes, and you can use that to kind of move around pretty quickly in the game. So let's see what I actually want to do first here. So I'm actually really far away from where I've liberated this city, but I'm actually doing more progress down here in the bottom. I think I'm going to try to do a couple cities here. I don't know about this one. Let's see if we can fast travel. Personally, I have not had any issues, technically speaking. The game runs basically between 70 and 100 frames per second pretty much all the time, except when there's a whole ton of explosions and it lowers a little bit. There's my wingsuit. And then you can transition that into parachute. Right, we'll go liberate this town here after we do a couple of experiments. There we go. I haven't had any crashes or any other technical issues in the game. Now, I know from reading the forums that some people have, so that's something to kind of keep an eye on now. I just, you know, basically, there's a mission I might actually want to do. Convoy rescue, I'll do that. Don't want to miss the opportunity to show one of those off. Now, other people have had issues, so that's something to keep an eye on if you have... Yeah, I got you. Oh my gosh. Why are you people running me over? Oh, and I got heat. And he called for backup. Alright, go. Bye. Oh. Yeah, and I just died. Well, so much for me saying the game's easier. Part of it is because I got run over first. Oh well. So there's stuff like that. There's like delivering cars and stuff like that. Kind of little random little missions you can do. It's kind of cool, even though I failed that encounter. So let's see. Let's go liberate this village. After I do some fun stuff first. Parachute. There you go. And let's go into town here. I mean, part of the game is simply messing around with the physics engine. How do I have heat already? I'm gonna steal your car. I'm gonna steal your car too. And I'm gonna have some fun. Alright. Let's tether these things together. And I'm gonna strap some explosives to them and we'll see what happens here. Now, this is the physics engine is pretty robust, so it actually matters where you attach these. I'm gonna try to make them go in the same direction. So I'll attach two to the back of this car. And we'll attach two to the back of this car, and then we'll see what happens. Alright. Yeah, there's tethers in the way, dude. I'd probably watch out if I were you. Okay, here we go. Cool guys, don't look at explosions. So we'll stand this way. Well, they're not even moving. That's disappointing. They're just gonna blow up. There you go. Oops, my bad. Oop, there's another encounter. Let's see if I can do that one. Getaway driver. Hey. Oh, sorry, dude. Leave him alone. I'm gonna get heat anyway here. I'll just blow you up. Bye. Nope, I didn't miss. There we go. Alright, so in each town there's a list of things you gotta take down in order to clear it. Ah, crap. No, stop. So there's one of the billboards. Looks like there's three. Now you can go onto the map once you defeat enough stuff, and it'll actually show where they're at on here. There's no mini map on here, which is disappointing. There's another billboard. There's two. Yeah, let me try to hide to clear my heat a little bit.
We are sending ground support to your location.
All right. This should do it. There's basically, you have to just hide for like 20 seconds and then they'll leave you alone. Until I blow up more stuff. And there's something I actually want to blow up. Speaker's gone. All the stuff you need to get rid of is all color-coded in red. Okay, so I escaped. Oh, let's see. Oh, hey guys. I don't think they're gonna like that too much. And you can hold down shift and it'll compress it a little bit. Alright, let me blow this up. Stop shooting me, I'm blowing stuff up. Hi. Take that. No. Excuse me, guys. Statue's gone.
Locate the rebel immediately. Do not let him escape.
I'd rather you not. Another speaker. Alright, getting down to it in this village. I do have to go to the kind of the fortress and figure out what to blow up there.
Unable to locate target. Terminate search.
Hey, I'll take that. Usually when I drive, I actually have... Oh, there's a tank. Let me get out of the way of that.
Contact
I don't think the tether is going to be enough to hold that thing. Here's the other billboard now.
Initializing search protocol. Find the target as soon as possible.
I don't even think I did anything to blow that up. Alright, where's the rest of the stuff? It's all on the other side of town. So we'll go over there. Oh, this way. Oh yeah, down, all down there. Yeah, I'm gonna meet some friends here in a little bit.
All units on alert.
Actually, this is what I'm gonna do. I haven't used a rebel drop yet, so I'm going to do that.
Sending additional ground forces to your
if I can get up this hill.
We've lost visual contact. All units,
come on.
Line out and search.
There you go. Alright. Yep, they found me. Is that a helicopter? Yes. I would like that to be my helicopter. Well, this will make it a little bit easier. Except I ran into the trees. Hi, guys. And I'm an excellent driver. Yeah, that's one way of getting in here. Hi. 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 I actually kind of like the gunplay in here. Seems better than before. Alright, let's just explosives on this thing. Alright. You're gonna get blowed up. Yep. It doesn't get old. Let's let these guys in. I need some rebels to help me out. Okay. Kapow. I saw some weapons around here. Yep, up here. See what we got. Nope. Not worth it. Picked up more grenades, though. Alright, what else do we got? We got that thing. Yeah, let's just do this. Hi. Alright, so I just got one more call on the rebels and I should be good. There we go. And we'll just take out the rest of these guys. Hi. Alright, so all I gotta do is raise the flag and I'm good. And that's pretty much it. You know, it does get repetitive with the villages, but with the different ways of... And that didn't work. And now my heat level's back up. Oh, this is...
Understood. We are providing additional manpower at your location.
But with the different ways that you can approach, you know, taking care of everything. Oh, there's the flag. You can be pretty innovative in how you take each of the villages. Yep, I'm awesome. Now you get a garage. When you bring, as you can see, vehicles to it, it adds to the drop list, which I'm actually going to do a drop ring. I actually would like to do the bridge blast. And the other challenge. I will do actually both of those challenges, I think. Let's go do that. Alright. Alright, let me take my other tether away. Alright, start a challenge. Yeah, you gotta crash on the target. Alright. So like I said, I use the gamepad for cars, and then, so I just kinda like sit it on my lap. A kilometer away. And I gotta figure out how to get there, unfortunately. Oh, that's cool. Traffic. Darn rush hour.
This is dispatch. Request received. Reinforcements on route.
Hi, guys. How am I supposed to get there? Where is this even at? Oh, okay, so I am going the right way, alright. Doesn't give you any directions or anything.
Copy that. Reinforcements inbound.
Okay. I still have 2.5 minutes, so I'll be alright. I don't know how that other guy got such a
tanks dispatched for your country.
Crazy score.
We are sending ground support to your location.
Crap, it's that way, isn't it?
Target is in charge. Re-establish visual contact immediately.
Ooh. Go! Didn't bail out. Ah, I died. I didn't bail out fast enough. Ah, shoot. I can do that again. Alright, let's try that one more time. Now that I know where I'm going. Alright. Out of my way! Excuse me. Oh, jeez, it's a car. I don't bail out fast enough. Well, the heck with that. You get the idea. Alright, where was that other mission? Over here? Alright. Let's go over there. Hi. Oh. Ouch. Alright, let's, I want to call in some stuff. Alright. Rebel drop. So you can call in two-handed weapon. Sure. A dual wield. And a special. Which you can see, these, most of these are unlocked by taking certain military bases. Yeah, I'll do that. And then a vehicle. I want a helicopter. And then there's a time limit if you call it in more than once. Alright, let me do this away from this car, at least. It is not throwing this. Hello, why? Okay. Yeah, I'd love to. I don't know why it's not throwing the beacon. That's really weird. Oh. Yeah, I know. I want to. Whatever. Well, I still want the helicopter. Alright, apparently I'm not going to do any of those. That's annoying. I have no idea why it's not letting me do it. That's the first bug I've ever encountered. Which car do I want to steal? I'll take your car. Hi. Bye.
Rebel activity reported. Get to the following coordinates immediately.
No.
Additional troops inbound.
Hi. Oh, I have no weapons now. That's cool.
Request received. Reinforcements en route.
I don't know what's going on necessarily.
Oh, change is good. News eye.
Pick up some grenades.
This is dispatch, come in. Why is no one responding?
I don't know what's going on. Yeah, I'll just take your thing. Tuck and roll, Grandma. Tuck and roll. Oh, yeah, there it is. Alright, let's do this challenge. It also means I gotta keep the airplane after I'm done, so. Assuming I don't die. Which is, really...
This area is restricted.
Shut your face. I'm an excellent driver. Oh, jeez. No, I'm not. This is quite disorienting. You have like boost in these airplanes too, I think you go faster. After I'm done with this, I'll show you the gears. Ugh. Assuming I earned some. The enemy vehicle was destroyed somehow. Thanks. No idea how.
Hey, Can I get more gears?
Ugh, I think I just barely got it. Yep, cool. Max flares. Definitely use that. Alright, so we'll exit that. I do have a new mod. So, as you do the little challenges and stuff, it unlocks mods. A bunch of different categories that you can enable if you want or disable them. I'm very terrible at the wingsuit courses, so that's probably the one that I haven't done the most. So, I'll do that. Definitely. So, a bunch of different things there. I don't know why my verbal drop wasn't working. Alright, so where are we at? We're near this town. Well, let's go liberate it, shall we? Or something. Ooh, yeah. Lots of stuff. Alright, well. Is there something tall I can crash into? Oh, there we go. There's a water tower. I'll crash into that. Alright, let's get out. Get out! Oh yeah. that was good. That was good. Alright, let's see how long I can survive in this thing. Considering I have, like, no weapons. Oh, hi. Oh yeah, I have no grenades. Excuse me. Sorry about your truck. See what else we can blow up here. Oh, okay. Excuse me. That was actually pretty cool.
Understood. We are providing additional manpower at your location.
Let's see if I can get this rebel drop thing to go. Still don't know why it wasn't working. I can clear my heat here in a second. This is actually a good spot for it. We're in this middle of the plane here. Alright. Try this one more time. I want to see what's going on with it.
Search target no longer an area.
Yeah, it is not letting me throw any beacons. I don't know why. That's so weird. Whatever. Well, there you go. I think that's a good look at it. That's Just Cause 3. I like it. I like Just Cause 2. Basically, the game adds, you know, obviously it's updated the graphics. I have no performance issues for me, although other people have reported them. You know, the game is very fluid, has a very nice physics engine. Let me cancel this double drop. And I'll have some fun while I'm driving here, while I'm talking. Oh, that's not really what I wanted to do, but okay. I want your car.
Wait, my purse!
Let's strap some explosives to this. Now, there's no multiplayer in the game, but I suspect that people, you know, just like they did with Just Cause 2, might mod into it later. Can I attach her to it? No, it just goes to the ground. Just have to wait for somebody to drive along here. Then I'll tether them to my rocket car. As far as complaints go, there's no minimap, which is annoying that you have to pull up this full screen map every time you're trying to find stuff. It has a very large game world. Oh, there we go. The rockets aren't powerful enough. No, that's alright. That was fun. You can go. You're free to go, sir. Oh, that was an enemy vehicle, too. That's right, I'm clear. There's no one else around here anyway. Even though there's no online multiplayer, it does have those leaderboards, which apparently make it, like, super laggy every time it tries to log in. Probably the process to when you double-click the game on your desktop to get into the game, for me, is probably about 20 seconds. Although 15 of that is spent looking at some unskippable little movie that it does at the beginning. I want a bus. I'm just going to take you for a ride. Don't mind me. You know, the main story can be completely ignored if you want. Yeah, move out of the way.
Oh, that looked bad.
And there are, you know, repetitive missions there. It's either a lot of escort or timed missions. What's in the way now? You? Yeah, there we go. Clearing the road. Yeah, go away. Now you can spend the rest of your time liberating villages, doing the driving plane challenges, the wingsuit ones that are really difficult for me, doing the little random encounters, or you can just kind of mess around with the physics, which is what I'm doing. Sorry, buddy. I don't know why I necessarily got in that or not. I think the game is best played in, like, hour bursts, where it does get the same after a while, but what game doesn't, really? I mean, what game isn't the same thing over and over again? I think that the way that you can approach meeting the objectives of basically blowing a bunch of stuff up makes this more interesting than, like, a more traditional game where it's basically just shooting people. Here you have a pretty good selection of weapons and vehicles and your tethers and tethering things together. You know, like tethering a rocket cow to a motorcycle. Why not? Your parachute, the wingsuit, gives you a lot of different ways of doing all of your goals in the game. I mean, if you like Just Cause 3, I think I like Just Cause 3. And I think it's really fun as I blow this van up. 5 AM. And the explosions look nice. Sorry about making you fly through the air. And he's running away. I'd probably run away too if I were him. So there you go. That's all I have for today. Till next time. Bye now.